also running logs. Yeah. So where is my university? So here is Tokyo and Osaka, Kyoto, and Kyushu University is in Fukuoka. Yeah. So this is the main Shikoku, and this is, we call it Kyushu Island. Kyushu University is in this island and in Fukuoka Prefecture. Yeah. And we have this amount of the students and yeah. This number of the students and the faculty staff, and all the students have to be bring their own devices in our university. And so today I have two topics: mobile learning in the context of the language learning, and also the learning analytics. So Roberta and I are organizing a workshop at the learning analytics and knowledge conference the theme is the learning analytics across physical time and location, something. Yeah, so mobile learning is not just provide learning at enable learning at any time anywhere, also provides the right information at the right time. Yeah, it's very important. So we have developed some software. And for example, here is the international student in the university. And actually, they have to learn some Japanese language. Yeah. To survive, I think, yeah. And she's a Japanese language teacher, yeah. And she provides some quiz, put some quiz in the specific location. And yeah, if the student go to some specific location, and then they receive the quiz, yeah. It's quiz is like this, yeah. So, but in this case, the teachers should prepare some quiz. Yeah, it's a it's not so sophisticated. Yeah. So here is another example. So we use RFID tag. It's a radio frequency identification tag to identify the physical object. We put RFID tag to the physical object like desk or something like this. And if he's a Chinese student and he enter to the room, and then this device ask a question like where is the microwave? But here we I wrote this in English, but actually the question is asked in Japanese. And if he scan the RFID tag of the microwave, then the answer is correct. Otherwise, it's not correct. Yeah. So it's a kind of the real world dictionary. Yeah. So for to learn vocabulary, to learn language, it's important to connect the vocabulary and vocabulary and the physical real world object. Yeah, so it's like something like this. Yeah. Okay, so this is okay. I will skip this one. And okay, so another example is we have also developed the a system called for scroll, system for capturing and reusing learning logs. So scroll is like this. So we want ask the student to record what they learned in their daily life. Yeah. So actually, the international students, they took a Japanese language course before entering the university. But it's not enough. So they learned they learn a lot of the vocabularies and Japanese expressions in their daily life. Yeah, so, I mean, when they are attending the course and or they are to buy something or they go to hospital or yeah, something like that. And so usually most of them have this kind of the note when they learn something and then write down. Yeah. But the so the idea is we can use smartphone to record, to capture their learning experiences, yeah, and share among the students. So unfortunately, this kind of the note, if they go back to their home country, so they bring back, so it's difficult to share the knowledge, but so we have more, we have a lot of the Chinese students actually, they learn, I thought they learned, there are some similar learning process, in terms of the vocabularies or something like that. So, we don't know yet how the students are learning, outside classroom, in their daily life. Learn how to learn the language, So, if I collect all the data, and then we can trace their path, learning path, and maybe we can provide some efficient learning path to this, a new student when they come to the, they enter the university, that's the idea, So we have developed the scroll system, and so the students should record the learning log by taking photos or recording videos, or something like that, and with the location and the time. So those information is just a clue to record their learning experiences, So, and the system allows the student to share the learning logs or with other users, and so also the system automatically generates the personalized quiz by using the stored data, learning log data, and provides a location aware service. So if I will give you some example later. And okay, so we propose this model, LOA model. We call it LOA is short for log, organize, and recall and evaluate. So actually, LOA means the knowledge that is not written down in the textbook. So, we want to record all the learning experiences. It's not written in the textbook. So we want to collect all the data by using this model. So in the logging model, so if the student learns some new words, then take a photo or record videos. So we call it active logging, But the problem is so student may forget to take a photo or something like that, So that's why we use this kind of the live logging cameras, So, we call it passive logging. So, in this camera, photos are taken taken in every 5 seconds or 10 seconds or something. So, I mean, this has sensors. So if he move, then the pictures are automatically taken, But the problem is there are a lot of the, photos are taken in one day. So maybe more than 5,000 photos. So but it's difficult to review all the photos. So we developed some filters, to show the students only the important photos. So okay, so in this case he found a student found this photos important, I mean, because the there are some Japanese characters. So in this case, the he students first registered this word in their native language, and then we used Google Translator to translate to the Japanese and also some English. And then provide some, if there are some similar vocabulary and the system shows this kind of photos and also locations. So this vocabulary is also, you can find these locations, So, I mean, the vocabulary is can be used in different contexts, so it's important to for the student to learn how this vocabulary can be used in the real world. So here is the single user's learning log. So even in one single user, so I mean, the user maybe forget. This user registered this words, but he already learned this vocabulary 1 month ago, or 1 year ago, and 3 years ago. So the system support to recall the the user's past learning log. And also this system allows the users to share the learning log so that they can share their learning log. So organizing process, the student can organize the learning log by the location and time and the keywords and something like that. Here is the tag cloud. And the reusing process, we are providing the quiz. There are two types of quiz. First one is context-dependent quiz, and the second one is context-independent quiz. Okay, so if the same user or other users go to the place where this learning log were registered, and then automatically the quiz is provided to the user. So the question is, they select the right word, this one, fire hydrant in this case. And this is the the right answer, and something like that. So I mean, why location is important? So one theory is encoding specificity. So the human memory is related to the location and also the some even smell or something like that. Yeah. So maybe if you want to remember something, then it's better to go to the place that you remember. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And also the picture superiority theory is the, I mean, if you compare the text and the pictures to remember something, I mean, so photo is more easy. You can easily remember, something. And also the spaced repetition theory. So, if you remember if you learn something, but it's not a good idea to remember every day. So you can have some, but you have to remember. Otherwise, you will forget. So, what is the efficient interval of the to remember? So this is the theory. So I think, for example, if you learn something and then you need to remember 1 week, and then 1 month later you have to remember, and then 1 year, and I mean interval should be more longer and longer, not the constant. So we use this kind of the cognitive and brain science theory to provide a quiz. So also, here is some augmented reality interface. I mean, you can browse running log around you like a Pokemon Go. you can browse there. So here this is your current location, and then here is there are two running logs around you. So here is the the system shows the walking path to go there. And then if you go there, you can learn some words. Something like that. So if you have questions, please ask me. So in the evaluation part, so you can, here is the map. So you can see the locations, and here is the timeline. And you can go back. This interface can be scrolled to the backward, and then you can find what you learned before, when and where. It's something like that. You learned before. And here is the graph to analyze the location. And I mean, this user learned this vocabulary in this place. So we call it three-layered graph. So in this case, this for example, supermarket, there are lots of the vocabulary. The link between the place and the vocabulary. Then this place is very important. If the student go to this place, they can learn many vocabularies. So just analyzing the graph. So we can understand where is important and who is the important who helpful to learn something or something like that.
For example, if you go to the supermarket, a whole lot of options for vocabulary come up on there.
So 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 if you run natto, yeah, in this case, in the supermarket, and then the system recommends what you can run next in the same place, or who can help to run it, or and also the when they learned this kind of vocabulary, and also where, I mean, around the supermarket, you can run some vocabulary in which location, something like that. This is kind of the recommendation, yeah, what students should go or should run, something like that, yeah. Yeah. It can be, yes. Yeah. Sorry. It's, okay. So here is some photos recorded in this system, and also we had already this number of the running log stored, and also yeah, and this system is used in 51 languages, yeah. So many people are using in different countries. So it's free. You can register, yeah. So can I move to the next one? Okay. So learning analytics in University of Education. So this is the concept framework for the educational system. So here is the school, and here is learner and teachers. And so learning and teaching process is very important, yeah, for the education system. So we don't know yet how the learning and teaching process is going. Yeah, going. So we want to understand and enhance the teaching and learning process is the core of educational research. Yeah? I mean, how? Yeah? Yeah? Yeah, okay.
My
okay.
Because I recently attended a seminar on systems thinking, and the systems would have an impact on all. That is like a very much semantic approach. So you cut one piece,
yeah,
and you present. Is that the most useful way to represent it? Because systems impact on everything.
Yes, yeah, yeah.
So I mean, to give you an example, in our university we have 143 different flows,
yep,
that go between systems learning, content, and teacher.
Yeah.
And that becomes the most difficult part of learning analytics. Whereas presenting like that makes it very easy.
Yeah, you are right.
Yeah. We should look at systems as a standalone item.
Yeah, yeah.
Or what we do is look at systems across everything.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah. You're right. Yes. So here is just about the learning analytics. So, okay. So since April 2014, so our university just started new curriculum to make students more active. I mean, in Japan, the most of the students are not so active. I mean, especially before entering university, yeah. I mean, the student just attend the course and take a note, yeah, and exam, something like that. But after entering the university, the student should be actively, should run more actively, yeah. Otherwise, they cannot get anything. So the problem is how we can make a student more active, yeah. So and to do so, we have to know how the student learning. We want to know how the learning process of the student, also the teaching process, yeah. So that's why we use the learning analytics. Yeah, we are doing research on what learning analytics. So for the first year student, we have 2,700 students. And yeah, of course, we have more than 200 subjects. I mean, for only for first year student to teach. So the, most of the teachers are using this kind of the PowerPoint slide in their course. So we asked the professors to provide all the lecture materials. And then we provide this material to the ebook system. We are using ebook system. And then all the students can access to the learning materials. And then system records the learner, the student activities, such as go to next page or previous page, underline, or make annotations, or something like that. So, we asked, as I said before, we asked professors to provide digital textbook and learning materials and put this data to the ebook system, and all this kind of the logs are recorded. Also, we integrate, we are also using e-learning system, Moodle, and e-portfolio system, Mahara system, and we integrate all kind of the data and then provide learning analytics tools like it's as a Moodle plugin, so everyone, every student and the professors can use this analytics tools and provide feedback to the student and teachers. Here is, you can see some So all the student has a laptop PC, and they are reading. They are using ebook system. So here is this ebook system, and also teachers are using ebook system, and we are providing learning analytics tools to the students and professors. We are using Moodle, and Book Looper is an ebook system. So it's not so. I skipped this one. We call it Mitsuba M2B system for three systems. So currently, this number of the students and the staff are using in our universities. And we, the Moodle is used in 700 courses or something like that. And we have already collected this kind of, this amount of data. And here is the Moodle interface in our university. So we are using this kind of the logs. This is as standard, it's a simple. And also, we ask the students and teachers to use Mahara system. For example, at the end of the course, the professors, teachers ask the student to write down the notes. Diary, kind of diary, So, what is the interesting point, or what is What do you feel difficult to understand or something like that? Yeah. And then here is, this is the ebook system. So see the slide in this application. And here is a list of the logs of ebook system. So user ID, and this is the action. So go to next page, and this is the time, and this is the content ID or something like that. Yeah. here is some, yeah. So most of the data is about the flipping a page. Flip means the go to next page or a previous page. Yeah. So underline or annotation is not so big amount of data. Yeah, it's small. So what we want to do is the, okay, so the professors should make a design, course design before starting the course and give the course, and then improve the course design, yeah, including the learning materials, yeah, syllabus or something like that. But the during the course, by using this system, automatically the data is, I mean, learning process and recording, teaching process are automatically recorded into this kind of data. And then by analyze this kind of data, the professors can improve, yeah, the course. Yeah.
Of how this data can be used to analyze, yeah, and make sense,
yeah,
for the program. Because, yeah, so far we have data, which is great.
Yeah.
I think all of us who collect this data in your team.
Yeah.
But the big question is, what sets of data,
yeah,
can be used for what purpose?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. So, it's okay. Okay, I will explain some analytics tools. Okay. Here is this graph shows the achievement rate. So 100% achievement rate means the student read the ebook learning material from first page to the end, then it's 100%. But yeah, actually this student, yeah, here is a student ID. So this student didn't read anything. Yeah, yeah, this is the reality. So I mean, if the teachers want to give some flipped classroom, and then as a student, please, you have to read learning material before attending the course. But the no, not all the students are. No. Yeah, in this case, I mean, if the perfectly student already read the learning material, then the professors can, I mean, give the exercise or can start the group discussion or something like that. The professors, they don't have to explain about the learning material. Yeah, as I mean, but the in another case, I mean, if the most of the students didn't read learning material before the course, and then the professors should explain, yeah, learning materials, yeah, at the beginning of the course. So I mean, by using this graph, the teachers can provide the, give the course, I mean, in adaptively, I mean, according to the student, yeah, current preparation condition. Yeah, this is just a statistical, I mean, graph, but it's powerful. Yeah, yeah. I mean, we didn't know yet how the students are learning outside the classroom. Yeah, and also here is the number of the markers. The graph, this graph shows the, this is a page, yeah? So we ask the student if the, there are some keywords if, which the student cannot understand clearly, then please make underline in yellow or something like that. Yeah. And then if we count the yellow line, underline, and then, I mean, this page, I mean, the student feel this page is difficult to understand. And then the teachers should explain about this slide, yeah? So this makes the lecture more adaptive way, yeah? Flexible, yeah. So something like that. And also we found some rules, yeah, to get high score. So if the student make preview more than 5 minutes in the first four lectures, not all the lectures, only the first four lectures, and then 100% of the students can get grade A. Yeah.
So the rules are coming from previous students and their achievement, or
yeah,
so it's basically you would have an algorithm which is telling you what previous students have done, and then comparing that to the current students.
A previous student. Yes. Yeah. Yes. Previous student. Yeah. Okay, so this is not, sorry, it's Japanese. So here is this diagram shows the page transition. Page transition means the student reads this page and go to next page and go to this page or something like that. So if the learning material is good, prepared good, then I mean student can understand just by reading from the first page to the last page. I mean it makes like a circle, yeah? But here is not smooth. so maybe we can ask the students. We can ask these professors to make some improvement. Yeah, to think about these pages. Yeah, so organize more. Organize. I mean. Think about the order of the slides, and content. And some learning materials can be the students should go there and skip there, jump to understand. It's not so good. And here is the real time data analytics. So. This is the timeline, and this is a page transition. So in the video, you can see the teachers and the students are using a e-book system in the classroom. Yeah. So red dot is this teacher's transition, page transition. So teachers explain about the first page and go to second page and something like that. And so most of the students are following teacher's slides, but the some of them are not following. So if the most of the students are looking still looking at the previous page, then the, in this case, the student completely not completely understand previous page. So I mean in this case the teachers speak very quickly and then the student cannot understand, cannot follow what the teachers are saying. Okay. Oh yeah.
It's about looking at it
afterwards. Our teachers can use this kind of can watch. Yeah, but this is I know this is very difficult to for the teachers and
that's
then
fine. How are students actually using the data that you provide?
This is the only for teachers.
Yeah.
Yeah. Not for students.
Yeah, but what do you find that teachers are looking at this and then changing the way that
they're thinking about it? Yes. And we conducted the comparative study. So, one class is teachers use this system, use this tool, and another class is teacher doesn't use this one. The classroom using this system got the better score than others.
So I have another question. Do you teach the teachers how to interpret this? Since this particular, I don't see there.
So
there are a number of students that don't follow.
So we have developed the new interface. This is just for the my presentation, so.
My question is how to interpret this, because it can also mean that the students are not engaged with what the teacher does, because the material is boring and they know it already, so we're not out of it.
Yeah.
And the other students just go ahead and see, this is coming up, and I have done that, so I'm going to do it again. It's a different interpretation, I'm saying.
You are right. We need more research. This is just starting point. Okay, but okay.
Is this in a lecture situation?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. So obviously part of the requirement for using this is to the person giving the lecture has to stick fairly closely to the text that they prescribed. So it can't really deviate from that much.
Yeah.
I just follow up on that, and I'm wondering how applicable this is in a context like Australian higher education context, where when we talk about active learning, normally we ask our tutors and our academics to actually divert and reach their teaching, pay attention, generate discussion.
Can I just ask too, if I'm a lecturer, can I identify which students are not on the page? Or do I just know that somewhere in the room there are that number of students who aren't on the page, but I can't?
You cannot and identify the student.
Stop and say, okay, this next point is really important. Yeah. I'll just give you 20 seconds for everybody to find
Okay. So here is another research. So This is the ontological support for ebook reading. So we asked the professors to generate this kind of the knowledge map, concept map for which kind of keywords the professors want to teach in the course. And the concept is also has a link to the specific learning materials pages. Yeah. So if the student read this specific page, then the teacher understand the student already understand this concept or something like that. So this kind of map can be helpful for the professors to understand the student background knowledge. I mean, I mean the student has a variety of background, so teachers want to know what they know already, yeah, before giving the course. So this kind of the.
So yeah. Those concepts are related to, say, previous units, texts that the students may have covered?
Yeah.
So the learning logs are individual to a student, and if they move from one course into the next course, history.
Yeah, history, yes,
so they
yes,
know,
yes.
So they might have done biology 100, yes. And so we know that they've read
Yeah, this can be also used for lifelong learning. So from the,
Does that mean the student could go back on this concept and go back to pages that they'd already read?
Yes. Yeah. It's links. And also here is the another project, we call it slide summarization. So. So the most of the professors provide all the learning materials to the student, before the course. But it's too much for the student. So we developed the tools to summarize the slide. I mean, only just 5 slides or 10 slides or something like that, according to their font size or color of the red characters or something like that. So in this case, the most of the students could spend that time for the preview. I mean, it takes only 3 minutes or 5 minutes. Yeah, it's okay. And then come to the classroom and then learn. And I mean, students, they don't know what they don't know. So just giving the hint, just giving the word, I mean, which they don't know before starting the course, then they can concentrate to attend the classroom. So we don't have to ask the student to understand all the things before attending the course.
Slide summarization personalized per student?
Not currently not personalized, but it's better to be personalized.
So what's the approach to summarizing a 90-minute talk into 5 minutes?
Yeah, we just using text analysis. Font size, maybe important keyword is maybe in large font, using large font on or red or something like that, color or something. Just using this one. We are not using some intelligent something. No. Just pick up the keywords. But
is this just a proof of concept, or is this something you have tried out with students?
We have already tried, we have some evaluation,
What do students think about
Student, Yes. I mean, we don't provide any explanation about the algorithm. How to choose this slide to this student. We don't explain, but we just provide a slide. Yeah, so. Yeah.
And was that the 5 minutes that you were talking about with their successful or not?
Yeah.
So there's a connection between who accesses these summary slides and who actually does work on the subject?
No. Actually, no. I mean, no. Yeah. This rule is not connected. So in this case, we just provide all the slides. Yes, yeah, 5 minutes, but if they are just browsing, not reading, just looking. Yeah, and then it's okay. That's why we provide these tools. Yeah, and also here is some statistics. So, this means the class lecture, take place these days, and I mean, yellow dot means the some student make a preview in 5 days before starting the course, and here is the high achievers. High achievers and low achievers, and we make a comparison. And okay, so after the course, there is no significant difference between high achievers and low achievers. So because the most of the course we have a final exam, so they made a review before the course. So, but the here is the significant difference because high achievers make a preview rather than low achievers or something like that. So that's why preview is more important than review, we think so. Okay. What time should I finish?
We have half an hour for questions. There have been some questions.
So here is the prediction score. So final score. To predict the final score, we use the data, last year, and then here is some, how can I say, it's kind of the statistical transition model to predict the final score, and then we use the last year's data and then predict this year's student score. Yeah. Oh, here is also the slide summarization. No. Okay. So we have several projects in this field. So about the Learning Analytics Center, we just established this center in this year. And we have 21 faculty staff and 5 technical staff. So it's me, and his major is information processing. Actually, his major is signal processing. And his education department, his major is education, and he's a psychologist, he's a neuroscientist, and he's a physics. He is teaching physics, and his major is e-testing, evaluation, e-assessment, and he's a mathematician, and he's a cognitive psychologist. She's a cognitive psychologist, and his major is data mining, and his major is text mining, and something like that. Yeah, so I mean, learning analytics is really interdisciplinary research. So we collect all the research fields. So here are the research grants. No, I mean, actually, we want to combine the this formal. I mean, Moodle and Mahara, we use this system, Moodle and Mahara, in formal education, and I just explain. And then also we can use scroll system to record informal learning process. So we can combine, I want to combine these systems. And also, we think the educational data science is become more important. Yeah. So it's an intersection of the computer science and education and cognitive science and something like that. So all the research method can be also can be changed. Yeah. Also the evaluation of the student and the teachers, because all the learning process and teaching process are recorded, so we can use this data to evaluate teachers, I mean teaching process and learning process. Yeah, we don't have to use the exam or something like that, maybe. Yeah, and also the lecture style can be changed. Yeah, it can be more adaptive way. Yeah. And also we can improve the education and the educational materials by using this kind of data. Yeah. So it's kind of movement towards the e-science and open science. Yeah. So it's a kind of okay. Yeah. And then, the data, educational data science, it's important to improve the teaching and learning. Yeah, that's all. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Very interested, you dropped in open science.
Yeah.
At the end. Now, there's not necessarily a connection between analytics and big data.
Yeah, but we have data.
Can you say more about open science?
Yeah. So, because we have data, so if we write a journal papers, and then you can provide data also. And maybe nowadays journal can be open access. You can access journal, and then also you can provide data, so everyone can access to the data, and then following research or something like that. Yeah, make some improvement. So some of the researchers, they don't have data. Yeah, so we have this kind of ebook data, so we can provide for researchers. Yeah. It's a kind of the concept for open science. Yeah.
So yeah, there is